Hello everyone, this is Swachh, IAS Academy welcomes you in the series of MCQs based on daily current affair. Today we will discuss the MCQs of 18th November, but before starting the video, you can download these PPTs from the link given in the description box below. And second, as soon as you see the question on the screen, please take a pause and try to answer it first and then see the explanation part. And try to get at least 7 questions correct. Now let's begin with question number 1. You have to consider the following statements regarding Fall Armyworm. So, two statements have been given. First, Fall Armyworm is a polyphagous pest. Second, the species is indigenous to India and has created havoc to standing crops in India. So, you have to choose the option which is correct. So, here statement second is incorrect and first is correct. So, answer will be A, one only. Now, let's see the explanation part. This is the image of pest. And it is polyphagous pest, that is, it has ability to feed on different kind of food, and it is native to tropical and subtropical regions of America, and it is not indigenous to India. That's why statement second was incorrect. And this pest was detected last year in India, and it is very invasive. For question number 2, you have to consider the following statements regarding Swachh Nirmal Tat Abhiyaan. Let's see the two given statements. First, it is an initiative of Ministry of Jal Shakti. Second, it is aimed to create awareness about the importance of coastal ecosystem and beaches cleanliness drives. You have to choose the option which is correct. So here the statement second is correct, first is incorrect. So answer will be B, second only. Here is the explanation part, and this Abhiyan is launched by Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change, not by Ministry of Jal Shakti. That's why statement one was incorrect. And it is mass cleanliness cum awareness drive in 50 identified beaches being conducted across 10 coastal states in UTs of India, and implementing agency of this initiative is Environment Education Division and Society of Integrated Coastal Management under Environment Ministry. Now question number 3, you have to consider the following statements regarding LaQshya initiative. So you have to consider the following statements regarding LaQshya initiative, and you have to choose the correct option. So in the given statement third is correct. So answer will be C, third. It is aimed to reduce preventable maternal and newborn mortality. Rest three are incorrect. Here is the explanation part, and this LaQshya is Labor Room Quality Improvement Initiative, and it was launched by Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, and please don't confuse it with Ministry of Women and Child Development. Now question number 4, you have to consider the following statements regarding karez system. First, karez system is an indigenous water harvesting technology of India. Second, it utilizes gravity alone to bring water to surface from underground source. So you have to choose the option which is correct. Here statement second is correct and first is incorrect. So answer will be B, second only. Here is the explanation part, and this system is actually water harvesting technology, but it is originated in Persia in Iran, and it is not indigenous to India. And recently, Suranga Bavli, situated in Bijapur, Karnataka, has entered the World Monument Watch List under Ancient Water System of the Deccan Plateau of the World Monument Fund. And it was built by Adil Shah I of Adil Shahi Dynasty of Bijapur in 16th century to supply water to Bijapura in Karnataka. And here the image is given. Now question number 5. Which among the following is the most abundant GHG, that is greenhouse gas, in atmosphere? Second statement is correct. So answer will be B, second, that is water vapor. Question part. The greenhouse gases are those that absorb and emit infrared radiations and are responsible for global warming. And here the chart of greenhouse gases are given. And you can see that water vapor is 49% of GHGs. And here is the order is given about this GHGs in Earth's atmosphere. Now question number 6. Recently, H-1B and H-4 visas were in use. You have to consider the following statements regarding these visas. First, the H-1B visa are lottery-based visas allow US companies to employ foreign workers permanently in specialized occupations. Second, spouse of H-1B visas workers are granted an H-4 visa. Third, the H-1B visa has long served as a common passes for Indians into the US. Fourth, most of the beneficiaries of these visas are from India. You have to choose the statement which is correct. So here only statement 1 is incorrect. Third and fourth are correct. So answer will be A, second, third and fourth. Here is the explanation part, and the statement 1 is incorrect because H-1B visas are low lottery based visas, but they are not permanently given for foreign workers. They are temporarily given. Now question number 7. Recently first edition of India Justice Report 2019 has been released. You have to consider the following statement regarding this. First, it is the first ever ranking of Indian state on justice delivery. Second, this report has been prepared by Ministry of Home Affairs. Third, the report has been prepared on four pillars of justice delivery, that is police, judiciary, prisons and legal aid. You have to choose the incorrect one. So in the given statement, second is incorrect. First and third are correct. So answer will be B, second only. Here is the explanation part, and the statement second is incorrect because Tata Trust in collaboration with Center for Social Justice Common Cause has prepared this report, note Ministry of Home Affairs, and the Commonwealth Human Rights Initiative has released it. And for this purpose, the states have been divided into two parts, the large medium states and the small states and UTs. And here you can check out other facts. Like Tamil Nadu topped in judiciary and policing, and Kerala topped in legal aid and prisons. Now question number 8. Thousands of migratory birds found dead in Rajasthan Sambhar lake. You have to consider the following statement regarding the lake. First, this lake is India's largest inland salt lake. Second, Sambhar has been designated as Ramsar site. So you have to choose the correct option. Here statement first and second both are correct. So answer will be C. First and second one. Here is the explanation part, and this wetland is key wintry areas for tens of thousands of pink flamingos and other birds that migrate from northern Asia and Siberia. Now, question number 9. The term white helmets was recently in use. You have to choose the option which is correct regarding this term. So false statement has been given, and in the given statement the option D is correct. It is volunteer search and rescue organization in Syria. Here is the explanation part, and it is officially also known as Syria Civil Defense, and it was formed in 2014 during Syrian Civil War, and recently it was in use because the prominent personality of this white helmets, he was James Lee Masurian, was found dead at Istanbul in Turkey. Now question number 10 and last of the series, Gambia filed Rohingya genocide case against Myanmar at ICJ, that is International Court of Justice. In which country it almost entirely located in? So four countries name has been given, and you have to choose the correct one. So the correct one is C, Senegal. Here is the explanation part, and you can see in the map that the whole country is entirely located in Senegal except the western coastline, which is along the Atlantic Ocean, and it is the smallest country within the mainland Africa. So here I am wrapping up today's MCQs. Hope you guys are liking the series. And in the last positive quotation, success consists of getting up one more time. So be consistent and work hard. Please subscribe our channel and press the bell icon to get the latest update of the MCQs. Please like, comment and share the video. And if you have any kind of doubt, please ask in the comment section below. Thank you.